Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we'll go through the quantum numbers as they will show up on your MCAT. Many students find this to be a tricky topic, but it doesn't have to be. My goal with this series is to help you understand how to quickly and easily calculate the different numbers for an electron, and I've also prepared a cheat sheet for you to follow along with, which you can find on my website at leiaforsci.com/MCATchemistry. Try to think of quantum numbers as an address. For example, if we look at chlorine on the periodic table, the atomic number is 17, which tells us 17 protons. And in a neutral atom, we'll have the same number of electrons. But the electrons aren't just randomly distributed in the electron cloud. Instead, every electron has a very specific address in terms of what level it's at, which orbital, and which suborbital. To help make this easier to understand, let's compare the periodic table, or the electron quantum numbers, to a college dorm. Say this is the building that houses the college students. When a student is assigned a room, the process for this dorm is to start with the very first level. So we'll fill up the first floor, then we'll fill up the second floor, then we'll fill up the third, the fourth, and so on. Within every floor, we'll have different types of apartments. If you have a studio, we'll only have one room in there. If we have a three-bedroom apartment, we'll have three bedrooms for students, five-bedroom and seven-bedroom. And every room will house a maximum of two students. Let's say the first floor is filled up with offices, and then all we have is one studio. The first two students assigned to this building will be assigned to the studio. We'll say that we have the A spot and the B spot, referring to the two parts of the room. The second floor happens to have one studio and one three-bedroom apartment. The way we fill this up is we start with a studio, we have the A student and the B student, and then we'll go to the three-bedroom apartment. But if we don't fill up every apartment, we want to put one student per room until every room is occupied, and then we'll add a second student as they continue to register. So for this, we'll call this the P apartment, and we'll fill side A for each one. Then we'll go back and fill side B, and so on. In doing so, we're following the alpha principle, where we start from the lowest energy, meaning the easiest to fill, and then go higher and higher. If it comes to the point where you don't have enough students to fill up an entire apartment, why would you have two sharing if they can each have their own room? The next thing we want to apply is the Pauli exclusion principle. And in the college dorm example, we're saying that no two students can have the exact same address. So for example, the students on the first floor studio will be assigned level 1, studio, and let's say A. The students in this room may be assigned level 2, apartment P, room 2, side B. Notice that we have four different designations to get more and more specific about the address. So how does this compare to the atom? We'll look at the table shortly, but the level is the principal energy level. That tells you what level of the building you're on. The apartment is the orbital, and it tells you which big door you have to walk through on that level. The room tells you the suborbital, so which room within that apartment, and then side A or B tells you if you have the upspin or the downspin electron. So now let's relate this back to the atom. The four quantum numbers that you have to know can be memorized by the mnemonic PEMS. We have principal energy level, which is N, and that will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. We have the azimuthal, which refers to the orbital, and that will be S, P, D, and F. We have the magnetic, which refers to the suborbital. The S orbital only has two electrons, so it's like a studio. It doesn't have rooms within that apartment. But the P orbital has the PX, PY, and PZ. The D orbital has five suborbitals, and F has seven. And finally, you have spin, which can be considered the right or left side of the room, the A or B side. In the electron case, it's considered plus a half or minus a half. In using the college dorm example, you hopefully have a general idea of what the quantum numbers represent in terms of an address for every single electron within an atom. Be sure to join me in the next video, where I show you how to break down the quantum numbers to understand the exact values that you have to know.
Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, the MCAT exam strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at MCATExamStrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.